Hello guys, a very interesting concept is group merger, which involves three variables. Now this includes concepts of allegation and deviation, which we learn in the chapter averages. All right, now have a look at this question. There are three classrooms, C1, C2 and C3. The average score of the number of students in each class is 75, 80 and 85. All right. When the three classes are merged together, the overall average becomes 78. You need to find out the ratio in which the number of students exist in the three classes. So N1 here represents number of students in C1, N2 in C2 and N3 in C3. Right? So average scores are given, the overall average is given. You need to find out the ratio of the number of students in each of these classes. Alright? So let's see. The concept that we use is net deviation from overall average is equal to zero. Net deviation is always equal to zero. An individual value can be more or less, but the overall deviation should always come as equal to zero. Okay? So look at deviation here. C1, 75 and 78, so it is less by how much? By minus 3. Right? Each student on an average has 3 less than the overall average. Okay. C2, each student on an average has plus 2. Alright. C3, each student on an average has plus 7. So this is the deviation. Now you need to make the net deviation as equal to 0. So mathematically speaking, minus 3 N1 plus 2 N2 plus 7 N3 is equal to 0. All values of N1, N2, N3 satisfying this relationship will be the correct answer. All values which satisfy this equation, because the net deviation should be equal to 0. Why minus 3 N1? How many people were here? N1, and per head deviation was minus 3. So total deviation is minus 3 N1. Here plus 2 N2. Here plus 7 N3. And the total deviation should be equal to 0. So one way of solving such questions is, look at the options. The option will give you the values of N1, N2, N3. Right? Put the values and see which option gives you the final result as equal to 0. The other way of solving, if let's say you don't have options, then understand, you will never get a unique solution. There can be infinite solutions. Any N1, N2, N3 group which satisfies the equation is going to give you the answer. Alright? But by hit and trial, you can find out the values. Not all values, but some values, and maybe those some values can be present in the options, right? None of these is there, that can also be a possibility. But let's try to understand what hit and trial means here. Okay, see, minus 3 plus 2 plus 7, total deviation should be 0, okay? Now one way of understanding this is, look at the positive side because it is greater. Plus 2 plus 7 is how much? Plus 9, right? To make the negative deviation as equal to minus 9, to make it 0, how many times do you take it? 3 times. So you do minus 3 into 3. Alright? Now this is equal to 0. A simple hit and trial. Getting it? So what was the ratio? C1, how many did I take? C1, I took 3 times. Yes, to get minus 3 into 3 minus 9. Plus 2 plus 7, how many times did I take C2? 1 times. And how many times did I take C3? Again 1 times. Right? So one possible ratio is 3:1:1. Got the logic? Yes? Minus 3 plus 9. How to make it 0? Take this 1 and take this 3 times. So one ratio is 3:1:1. Let me give you another example. Alright? This is minus 3. I'll make this a multiple of 3. How? Let's see. So this is 7. So let me take this 1 times. To make this positive side a multiple of 3, let me take this 4 times. Alright? So 4 to ja how much? 8. 7 1 ja how much? 7. So this becomes plus 15. Now how many times do you need this now? You need this 5 times. So see, ratio, if I take the ratio, 5:4:1. Have a look at the deviation. 5 into 3. Minus 3 is how much? Minus 15. 4 into plus 2 is how much? 8. And this one is 7. So what is the net deviation? It is equal to 0. So see, different different values are possible. 3 is to 1 is to 1 also gives us 0. 5 is to 4 is to 1 also gives us 0. So one possibility can be you are given options and you do hit and trial and see, okay, this option is right. Other possibility is put the values of the options in this equation and see which equation is giving you the final value as 0. What you need to remember primarily is that there is not a single unique solution. There can be infinite number of such solutions. Alright, I hope this concept is clear. Thank you.